spark fear in your opponents with the Prince Phantom 100X 305. With the second generation of Phantoms, Prince launches the Phantom 100X 305, formerly known as the Phantom Pro 100, with a thicker, more powerful beam. The racket provides a comfortably dampened feel thanks to its anti-torque system, which optimizes Techstream and Toro materials in the hoop and shaft for better stability and power. Thanks to CTS technology, the racket has variable beam thickness for excellent energy return. The racket features 11.4-ounce strung weight, a 321 swing weight, and a stiffness rating of 58. First up on this playtest, we have Julie. Now, recently you've been leaning more towards the tighter string patterns, the 1820. Your racket of choice is a TF40 305. However, this Phantom, it has a 16x18 string pattern. How'd it work out for you?
Well, I actually enjoyed it. And it's obviously not a control-oriented racket. It's a 16x18 string pattern, a low flex, a thin beam. So I was actually surprised with the level of comfort I got with this frame. I had also like easy power and spin with that open string pattern. And I was really impressed with the level of stability considering the specs. So I really thought that was a really good versatile racket with a really nice flex to it. And it really helped me crafting my game. So I was really able to be very aggressive from the baseline and also reach cross-court angles. And at net, I was actually surprised with the stability I had as well. Really nice depth with this 16x18 string pattern. And I got a lot of power also on my overheads and serves. And I was able to reach more targets on my serve, though I would have want a tiny bit more control. Like you said, I've been liking control-oriented frame lately and low power frames. So that's the only little downside for me with this frame. So it's also not the most maneuverable option that we have out here, but considering my liking for the low powered frames, for me, I found plenty of maneuverability. Overall, it's a really good racket, a great option for the aggressive player that wants to add some craft to their game.
I was also on the playtest, and being a fan of Prince rackets, I'm always excited to see what Prince has released. And I got to playtest this racket side by side with the 03 model. And like the 03, I had about an hour adjustment period, but once that hour was up, I really started to click with the racket. From my ground strokes, I found the racket to just feel really solid and plush feeling. It has great control, great spin for me. It is a little bit lower powered compared to my racket of choice, but that just forced me to just add a little bit extra racket head speed, and I was getting that pace and depth that I was looking for. I'm typically a big fan of the 03 technology. However, I was actually really enjoying the solid beam version. I just felt a little bit more connected to the ball. Up at net, this racket was great for me. It was solid and plush, but I also found it maneuverable enough that I could get the racket in position and put away the ball. When it came to serves, I actually was able to hit a variety of serves. I liked kind of mixing it up when I was playing. I could hit a real flat first serve and then kind of mix it up with a slice on the next one to really keep my opponents guessing. I preferred to return with this racket though, like most rackets. I just found it to have a solid feel, and I found it to be plenty maneuverable for my game. Overall, this is another solid option from Prince that'll satisfy a variety of game styles. We're gonna now send it over across the country to our playtesters at our East Coast location. Kristen, what did you think of this racket?
Thanks, Brittany. I came into this playtest with the previous model, the Phantom Pro 100, as my racket of choice, so I was really looking forward to this update, and it did not disappoint. From the first couple ground strokes I hit, it was very apparent that the stability was much improved with this update. I could also notice that the ball was leaving the string bed just a touch quicker, meaning I was getting greater access to free power, and all of that while still maintaining that really comfortable pocketing nature that I love. So I was getting a great balance of control, easy targeting, so just really quick to get dialed in there from the back of the court. It still has that great maneuverability, really whippy nature for getting around the ball for great spin and great angles. So optimal update for me from the back of the court. And then moving into net, I've been playing a lot of doubles with this frame, and it's just been really impressive. That added stability counteracts pace really well. I have more put away power, and I still have that great feel for touch shots. And then over to serves, it was definitely one of my favorite portions of the playtest, probably because that's the one area I struggled the most with the previous model when I was competing. I was missing a bit of punch. With this update, I could really tap into more free power. I felt really connected to the ball. I could pick my spots really well. It felt really whippy overhead, so I was getting great spin. So overall, just a really optimal update there as well. So needless to say, it was a really easy decision for me to switch my racket of choice to this update. I definitely think it's gonna be a fun one for you guys to check out. Eric was also on this playtest. It seemed like you were really finding your groove with this racket. What were your thoughts?
Yeah, I absolutely love this Phantom 100X305. Last year, you and I were hitting with the Phantoms, and I was also hitting with the Techstream Tour 100-310. Love the stability of that racket, but I love the plushness of the Phantoms. This racket is kind of the best of both worlds with the two rackets. They stiffened up the beam a little bit in this 100X305, and so you still have the great plushness of the Phantom, but you also have that stability of the Techstream. So it's kind of the best of both worlds. Absolutely love this frame. From the ground strokes, it was super whippy. I feel like I could do pretty much anything with the ball, honestly. Loved it, still super plush, silky smooth. On the volleys, same kind of deal. Touch volleys were incredible. I feel like I could do anything. Weigh my shots accordingly, absolutely perfect. The plushness of this, again, standout feature for me. It's always a standout feature in the Phantoms, but love that characteristic of these frames. On overheads, good directional control. Serves, I got a good amount of directional control and power as well. So that's really nice as well. And on returns, could easily block back returns if someone was hitting a really hard first serve at me, or take a cut at the ball and really get my opponents on the move. So overall, absolutely love this frame. I am making the switch to this officially and can't wait to continue playing with it.
We strung up the Prince Phantom 100X305 with a variety of string setups. For today's review, we strung it up with Prince Vortex Triad at 52 pounds. Our West Coast playtesters used Prince Tora XP and Slinko Hyper G at 52 pounds. For more information on this racket or others, please head to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.